So welcome to Reykjavik, Iceland, and today we're gonna go shopping in Reykjavik, check out the Handprjónasamband Íslands, or the Handknitting Association of Iceland, and see it over here. So if you wanna go straight to the source, buy paint from knitters, then this is the place to go. And this is here by Skólavörðustígur. Skólavörðustígur is the home of the beautiful Hallgrímskirkja Church. So, you know your bearings. Just down the road by Hallgrímskirkja Church. And yeah, let's check it out. Some Christmas-oriented things over here.
Hello.
Hi there.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good. What's your name?
My name is Helga. Doug.
Helga.
Yes.
Hi, Helga.
Hi.
My name is Valur.
Hi.
So can you tell us a little bit of what the Handknitters Association is? How long has this been operating?
It has been since 1977.
Okay.
There were a few ladies who came together and started this.
Okay.
And today we are about 500 members.
Okay, 500?
Yeah.
Okay, all over Iceland?
All over Iceland.
Okay.
And we, all of us knit, but some knit more than others. So we have around 350 active knitters.
Okay, okay.
So.
Beautiful. And you know, they knit all over Iceland, and then they, do you have more shops than this, or?
We also have in Borgartún.
Okay.
There is where the ladies bring their sweaters. I say ladies because we have them all ladies. I think we have two men.
Okay.
And some of them have their husband helping them, but mostly they are doing this, yes.
So two guys are knitting, that's the total
of
300. Okay.
Yes.
But still, okay.
Yes.
And so they bring their merchandise or their wool things over there, and then you distribute it over here also for them.
Yes, we put. We tell them what we need, we tell them, we give them the wool and everything,
okay.
And the pattern, and then they go home and knit it, and they bring it to us, okay. And we always tell them what size we need.
Okay, so yeah. So.
And then we measure them, and then we put our
logo.
Yes, and everything on it, and yes, put it in the stores.
Okay, okay. So the patterns are decided by the association.
Yes. We tell them what we need.
These are the state patterns of Iceland.
Yes, and also we do special orders, then we ask someone to do it. But
okay.
Mostly we have some of those patterns, because we cannot just have like a hundredth of something and zero of something else.
Yeah,
so that's
course.
Why we tell them
so
what we need.
So you try to standardize it a little bit.
Yes, we do. We try that. And but it's like they get the wool and everything, they go home, and then just when they are finished, they bring it. It's not you have to be here next Monday or Tuesday. You just take your time.
Yeah, take your time.
Yeah, some do it like quickly, others have it for a longer time.
Okay. So what's like the most popular things here? What we like to then show
us? This is just the gloves and everything like that. And
okay.
Down here we have the sweaters.
Okay.
Okay. We have a few sweaters.
Mm-hmm. A few.
A few, exactly.
I can see the need to standardize a little bit. You know, it would be
yes.
It would be a little bit random if you'd take all the patterns that are available.
Exactly. You see, we have like this pattern. We have this in like a lot of colors.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
And every sizes. You see, it's the same. We just put it in a different. Mm-hmm. With the different colors.
Yeah.
And then we have like this one also, and we have it in a different colors and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And those are like the natural and the cardigans.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have them in the colors and the cardigans.
Okay. Beautiful.
So it's like, and
no
the
problem.
Different
it's
ones.
Okay. Oh. Yeah.
It's okay. And then we have like a different kinds down here. Then we have like a price tag on it. It's a maybe different wool, mm-hmm. different style.
So you know what's the difference with Icelandic wool different, you know, to Norwegian wool or whatever? I know there are two layers.
They
are using like the
yes.
the inner and outer layer.
Exactly, and it's like the farmers collect it and give it to Eastex, and Eastex takes all the wool that we are making out of now. And it's like the wool is, they spin it like, these are made with plötuloppi. It's like unspun wool, and these have three threads. And then we have like some with two threads and some with one. And then like spun wool, like loppy light. Then it's like loppy light, something like this. And then the price are a little bit different. It's all, it's like, we price it like how many hours it takes the knitters to knit it. Because this one have smaller needle size and difficult, you know, so it's...
It takes a longer time to...
It takes a longer time. Those stitches are bigger, so it's like that.
So what's like a standard price for a, like a wool sweater, like a regular wool sweater?
Like this traditional Icelandic lopapeysa like this is 27,200.
Okay, reasonable.
So,
and do you have any more things to show us? So the cardigans, there are different buttons that you're using?
Yes, the cardigans have, with the traditional ones, they have our logo on it. So the, here is the logo, Handknitting Association.
I'm going to zoom here so you see it clearly,
And this is the sheep horn.
Sheep horn, of course.
And you can see the stitches also. There's like a stitch, it makes a stitch.
Okay, perfect. So you, you're using the brand of the Handknitters Association, of course.
And you cannot buy them here, you just get them with your sweater. So it's like...
It's like a one of a kind.
Exactly. This is our, And every sweater we can see, we put a, this piece, how this is ours, you know, put our logo on it. And we can see in every sweater who made it.
Okay, so you can trace it back to the origins.
Exactly, so and can I say, can tell everyone who knitted it and gave her the name.
Okay, beautiful. So you can basically say, Gudrun in the north of, you can go visit.
I can do it like that, yes. You see, because like this one is knitted, it's a number 401. So then I can go in the computer and see her name.
Member 401.
Exactly.
Beautiful. I like history, so this is a, you know, this is a straight from the source, like we tell you. So what's more exciting here?
We have like a different brands. I mean, we have with the Álafossloppi, then they are thicker with the zipper or and zipper and a hoodie.
Okay.
We have like this loppy light that I show you with the zipper, and we have it also zipper with the hoodie.
Nice.
And I mean, we can do almost everything, you know. We have different styles, different, and this one, you know, we can do...
All kinds of...
All kinds of, yes. At least we try.
So, different types of wool, some thicker, some thinner. Julie is asking, is my blue cardigan from this shop? No, my mother knitted that, so that's straight from the source.
Okay.
So anything more that you would love to show us? What's like what's very popular items to buy here in the store?
We have also blankets. We have wool.
Okay.
And we have.
Yeah, you can buy straight from the source, like the wool, to make your sweaters at home over there.
Exactly.
And I see the Santas over there.
Yep.
Well, that's also one of the things that I know my guests are always fun to check out. You see the monstrous Christmas cat over here, and all the different types of the Yule lads or the Christmas Icelandic Santas. And here we can see some posters with Icelandic horses and different types of colors of Icelandic sheep and cows and horses and. The one and only Icelandic sheepdog.
And then up here we have like a lot of souvenirs. Up at the other place.
I'm gonna take a little bit of a round here, just so people can. So here you can buy straight from the Inroom. Is that a new brand?
It's like an infant or Létloppi with some silk.
Okay, light. Loppi,
Létloppi.
What's the English? Do you know? Loppi. Wool, just the wool. Wool, yeah, yes. Lopelite. Lopelite. Mm-hmm. Can people order?
Sweaters, they can order everything that we sell.
Can you put it up for me? Mm-hmm. So buy directly from the people who make it, and that's at handknitted.is. Mm-hmm. Handknitted.is. So you can buy like a, if you want to try your, how about the patterns? Can people also buy patterns from you, or
yes,
how does that work?
Yes, we have like the books that East Techs are selling.
Okay.
So it's like this is the newest one. Then we have it in Icelandic.
Can you open up for one?
And English
one?
And yeah, and the okay. Patterns are.
Okay. Okay. Beautiful.
This one is in Icelandic.
So they can also order like a book and some wool and
yes.
And you know, start working it out.
Exactly.
Is there any on handknitted.is, is there any like educational videos like teaching people or can you recommend any?
We have been talking about having and but somehow we haven't started because
okay.
We have been busy, but
yeah, of course.
The mention is to do something like that, yes.
Okay,
so
cool.
It's in the process to do something.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Sounds good.
And you see when I said the this is the platelope. It's really breakable.
Mm-hmm.
And we use like 3 threads when we make the traditional ones.
So you're knitting 3 threads at once?
Together.
Isn't that difficult?
Well, everything is probably difficult
yeah.
In the beginning,
yeah,
but we get used to it.
Yeah.
And Icelandish people, like the kids, learn to knit at school, so.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one of the courses that you get in school, that you can learn how to make these kind of items.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to go and
okay.
Work, I will just work.
Okay.
Thank you. No, so she had to run. There's a full store of people here. People following me here into the store. No. But 27,000 in dollars is roughly $250, something like that, or no, less, $220, I'm gonna say that, Jody, $220, and how much is in pounds? It's 180, it's 170. 80 pounds, maybe, something like that. Head to the basement. Is there a basement also?
That's where I have all my other sweaters.
Ah, okay. It's the storage. I'm not sure that the Wi-Fi will, or the 4G will be able to connect over there. So
no,
yeah. It's just a storage area.
Yeah, because it's 4-ply.
That's a beautiful one. How much is a standard, like a lope, like the
like plate lope?
Yeah.
1 kilo is 5,200.
Okay.
Lope light is 410 kroners.
Okay.
Álafoss lope is 600. 70. It's
okay.
Been sold out.
Like,
690. Sorry.
Okay.
So I haven't been using it.
Yeah. So just like $4, like for that one, and the other one $3.
Mm-hmm.
So excellent. I'm gonna.
And it's like you know we have all kinds of
patterns.
Yes.
Nice
and then
one.
It's like if you want it in a different color, then we can just do that.
Mm-hmm. So you can order this. They can also order like sweaters online, right?
Yes.
Okay. Beautiful.
On the website,
we
are always adding more and more in there.
Mm-hmm.
They are now a few. So.
And if you see anything on the live stream, then you can maybe just reach out to their email and ask about it. I think they are very accommodating with that. And that's it. You know, there are a couple of stores that are unfortunately, selling Chinese knockoffs. And so you wanna go straight to the source, buy straight from the knitters, not, yeah. Some nice looking socks and all kinds of things. Hi Jody, how many knitters supply them? She was talking earlier that they are about 300 active knitters, but about 500 people that are in the Hand Knitting Association, but roughly 300 that are, you know, working actively. And I like it that they, you know, they came together and kind of like worked out the patterns and the right wool to make it from, and so it's a little bit like standardized, and you know you're getting quality. Linda, there's always time for a wool sweater. Even though you're in the middle of a heat wave now, nothing lasts forever. Hi, Samantha. Hi, Carol. The name of the actual store is the Hand Knitters Association by Skólavörðustígur. Skólavörðustígur is the street that Hallgrímskirkja Church is by. So just straight down from Hallgrímskirkja Church, and then you'll see this on the right hand side if you're walking down from Hallgrímskirkja Church. How much is a wool, like a blanket?
How much are the blankets?
Yes, like a similar, like a typical price.
From 13,400, about.
Okay. So 13,400, that's roughly $80, something like that.
And if they are hand knitted or hand crocheted, it's more.
Okay. Bob, the website address is handknitting.is. Handknitting.is. Patty is asking, is it dry clean only?
No, we wash them by hand.
Okay.
By lukewarm water.
Okay.
But we air them a lot. Put them outside. Okay. I mean, it's always windy in Iceland.
Yes, that helps.
And the wool is like, kind of cleans it, you know, if there's a little bit something, then you take a cloth and wipe it off.
Yeah.
But otherwise you can just, yes.
Just wash it in lukewarm water.
Yes.
And
then you put it lay flat.
Yeah, lay flat.
Yes. And we always give everyone like a piece of paper how to take care of it.
Mm-hmm. Can you show me that paper? Do you have
it
here?
Have it.
So let's let's zoom in on that one. Okay, I'm gonna
put it here. It is. And the size is good. Yeah, I think so. I'm pregnant, so I'm trying to find something that's...
So these are the small stains and spills can easily be wiped off with a damp cloth to get rid of any smell. Leave the sweater outside and let it breathe. That will usually do the trick. If you feel you need to wash the sweater, hand wash it in lukewarm water and use a gentle wool soap or shampoo and make sure to rinse it thoroughly. Lay the sweater flat on a towel to air dry. It can take a few hours to dry completely. Don't hang the sweater up, especially if it's wet, then you can stretch it out. The wool cleans itself, so try letting it breathe or wiping it down before washing.
Yeah. out of those.
Yeah. So is there a flokakonan.is?
Yes.
Flokakonan.is. So she's
so
Kata is the one responsible for this one. These guys, or people, persons, or elves, what have you? And puffins, and horses, and the works. Yeah. Okay.
I guess it's sold out.
Of course, it's sold out. Everything is everything related to a volcano is sold out in Iceland.
Exactly. And it's also like cocoa color. We have a lot of brands like this also. Mm.
Nice.
Like different. Mm-hmm. People all around Iceland.
Mm-hmm. So some Christmas, mm-hmm. Christmas ornaments, mm-hmm. and see it also over here. There's no, there's always time to add some Christmas ornaments. And yeah, here are some like items that are on sale.
Yes, these are not handmade.
Ah, okay.
So.
Varma. Mm-hmm. But they are made in Iceland, right?
They are made in Iceland, yes.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, I'm just waiting.
She's still in there. Like a bottle warmer. Nice couple of bottle warmers.
It's better to take the time and have
it for a. So yeah guys, a little bit of an introduction to the Hand Knitters Association of Iceland. And you can drop them a line at handknitting.is and they can do orders of all kinds of stuff. And yeah, I guess we say bless bless.
Handknitted.
Sorry?
Handknitted.
Handknitted.
Yeah.
Okay. Handknitted.is. Yes. I'll post a link a little later on. I'm gonna grab a poster and bring it on. But this store is just, you know, just here. If you look at the landmark of Reykjavik, the Handknitting Church, and you walk down there and then you'll see this nice little store here on the corner. Just to get a little bit oriented, you can see here on the right side you have a ice cream store. So this is a little bit of a on a small crossroads. Great restaurant over there. And then we have the Hand Knitters Association here in the basement of this. Buy directly from the people who make it. Skólavörðustígur 19. So I'll be back in about 30 minutes, I believe, from Café Loki. Café Loki up here by the Hallgrímskirkja Church. We're going to check out some traditional foods over there and talk about a little bit about that wonderful restaurant. So see you soon. Bless.